Hi guys, welcome back to today's ChargerLAB. Many audiences requested us to check what's inside of STORM2 Slim power bank, because we did tear down the 1.0 version of STORM power bank. If you haven't seen it, you can click the upper right corner to take a look. What we got today is only sold in China, so the shell and packaging of the product will be slightly different from STORM2 Slim, but the model and the internal components are the same. You can click the link in the description and go to their Kickstarter page to know more about the STORM2 Slim power bank. Open the box, and this is the power bank. It continues the see-through design, achieves transparency by displaying itself from the inside out, and reveals its sophisticated PCB, just like STORM2. Here are the specs: 20,000 mAh, 72 Wh, so you can take it on board. And here is the blue finish. Press the power button, the display will light up. It can show the battery life, charge cycles, output distribution per battery cell, running temperature, etc. It is equipped with a USB-C and a USB-A port, and the spec information of those two ports is at the bottom. And then let's check its size. The length is 156mm, width is 64mm, and the thickness is 31mm. The weight is 447 grams. Compare it with iPhone 12 Pro Max. Use ChargerLab Power ZKT002 to test the particle. The USB-A supports Apple 2.4A, Samsung 5V 2A, DCB particles, and QC23, AFC, FCP, SCP, PE2 fast charging particles. The USB-C supports QC4, PD3, and PPS fast charging particles. And USB-C also supports 5 fixed PDOs of 5V, 3A, 9V, 3A, 12V, 3A, 15V, 3A, 20V, 5A, and 1 PPS of 3 to 21V, 5A. Then let's try to charge some devices to see how it works. Next, let's take it apart. Firstly, remove the screws and the bottom plate. The plate is pasted with foam, which acts as a buffer against the vibration. The battery pack is encased in a translucent fire-retardant PC case, and the blue metal plate can support the PCB and dissipate heat. The PCB adopts the ENIG process and is fixed with screws and the yellow plastic clip. Continue to remove the screws on the PCB and the plastic clip. Here is the junction of the wires. The black one is connected to the thermistor. Remove the metal plate of the other side, which is also pasted with foam. Two USB-C ports are soldered on both sides of the PCB to save space. Remove the PCB, and there is a layer of thermal pad on the back for heat dissipation. And then remove the display. The front of the PCB is equipped with an MCU, step-down control IC of USB-A, MOSFETs, inductor, filtering capacitor, etc. the protective MOSFETs, protocol chip of USB-C, and the bug boost controller are on the back. This is the battery monitoring and protection IC, marked with MT006C6UB. Here are 6 MOSFETs for lithium battery protection, marked with B3115. This is the solid capacitor for input and output filtering, 25V, 100 microfarad. The MCU is marked with AOC18220F and is responsible for data collection, power control, and display drive. The flash memory stores data and comes from Boya Micro BY25Q80BS. The protocol chip with USB-C comes from Chipsea CS32G020K8U6, which integrates ARM M0 core, 4GB LD-ROM, and 8GB SRAM. It's suitable for power adapters, phone chargers, car chargers, USB hub, etc., and is available in QFN24 and QFN32 packages. And here is the DC bug boost controller of USB-C, which is used for the voltage conversion of USB-C. Model is Powlicon PL5500. It integrates 5V, 55mA LDO, and multiple protections. And it also supports wide input voltage of 3.5 to 32 volts, output voltage of 2 to 32 volts, and different working modes. Those 4 MOSFETs come from FETek FKBA4052 and can work with Powlicon PL5500 to bug and boost. 40V, 8.5 mΩ. This huge cube is 3R3 bug boost inductor. This is another solid capacitor used for USB-C filtering, 25V, 100 microfarad. The step-down protocol IC of USB-A come from Ismartware SW3521, which integrates a 3.5A high-efficiency synchronous step-down converter. It also supports multiple fast-charging protocols and CC-CV modes. Here is the 220 step-down inductor. This final solid capacitor is used for the output filtering of USB-A, 25V, 100 microfarad. Here are the receptacles of USB-C and USB-A. There is a film that separates the PCB and battery. Take out the battery pack, which is wrapped by plastic film, and 4 battery cells are connected in series. And then wrap those wires for safety. There are insulating fish paper and film between battery cells, and 3 wires are wrapped by insulation tube. The thermistor is reinforced by glue, used to monitor battery temperature. It adopts 21700 batteries, which come from Bake N21700CG-50. Each capacity is 5000 mAh, 3.6 volts. The charging limit voltage is 4.2 volts. Maximum continuous discharging and charging current is 15A and 5A, respectively. Well, that's all components of this power bank. Compared to the previous STORM2, it has reduced nearly 50% of its size, making the power bank even more compact and portable. After taking it apart, we found it's composed of 3 metal plates which can form a stable structure, and there are lots of foams that can reduce vibration. Besides that, the internal metal plates can dissipate heat. 4 big battery cells are connected in series, and 2 independent bug boost circuits are on PCB. The USB-C can support 100 watts and is controlled by Chipsea protocol chip, and USB-A adopts Ismartware SW3521 for protocol identification and step-down output. Okay, that's all for today's video. If you want to compare it with other power banks, you can click the corners to view it. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. I'll catch you guys in the next video.